And so many people's plans have, of course, been affected by the virus, including our very own amazing Team Rickshaw, who are all now completing the challenge from their own homes, with time running out to hit their new impressive target, which we will remind you about later. We'll be live with Matt and all the latest from the team.
Yeah. They've been pedalling hundreds of miles all week. I can't wait to catch up with them. So come on, let's all get behind them, eh?
Also on the pedalling almost non-stop in their epic challenge ahead of tomorrow night's Children in Need.
They've been clocking up hundreds of miles to try and hit the new target of 603 miles, which is the distance from Land's End to John O'Groats.
So let's go live now to Matt. Matt, now then, how have the last 24 hours been? And good evening. There you are. You're still there, Matt. You trooper.
I'm still here. Hopefully my connection's still up and running as well. But how have the last 24 hours? Oh, my gosh. Well, I haven't moved very far in person. It's like a lot of miles. What's been happening the last 24 hours? Well, thank goodness for Instagram. That's what I say. Thank you all so much for keeping me company. I did a brilliant live straight after the One Show last night, so we had so much fun on there. What else has been? Well, I was up very early this morning. There was a beautiful sunrise over the back of the house. I'm still here on my patio with this rickshaw chocked up on. Just started legs. I joined Joe Wicks, which was fantastic, for a bit of a cycling workout. And then obviously throughout the whole day, we've been backwards and forwards with Team Rickshaw as well. So many wonderful conversations, great company, even if it is virtual this year. It's a bit strange, really, because normally, obviously, I'm cycling all these miles with Team Rickshaw literally at arm's length away from me. But everybody's all over the UK banging out the miles as we do every single year. So here's a few highlights of what we've all been up to and what we've been talking about today.
With time running out, the team are up against it to meet their target.
How many miles are you on?
I just hit 10k.
Is it 10? 7 miles.
Yeah. Well, obviously Jim is not with us, but I can tell you he sends his love. And he's still a big part of Team Rickshaw.
Yeah, yeah. Always.
He and started Jim, the challenge.
Exactly, yeah, Owen. And you know what? We're going to get to the end and he is going to be a massive part of this year.
Rosie is 19 and now looking forward to going to university. As a child, she was diagnosed with cerebral palsy and has had difficulty walking throughout her life.
It's scary for me because as I was getting older, I realised I was different to everyone else and like it kind of took a toll on me. I do often feel trapped by my disability. Sometimes I want to just, like any other young adult, I want to go to a party or I want to, you know, go to the shops by myself. So that's really taken a toll on my mental health.
And how did Children in Need help change your life?
Without Children in Need, I wouldn't be where I am. They helped me with my physical side, but also the academic side as well.
How were you feeling about going to university?
At first I was like, I don't know if I'm like strong enough to actually get through this. It's taking time, but I'm learning to adapt.
And how difficult do you think it was for your parents to let go?
Oh, I think it was more difficult for them. It's always going to be tough seeing your little one move on. My mum, she's proud of me because of what I'm doing.
You're such a brilliant young woman.
What you have to do is like power through and just know that those hard times don't always last.
I'll tell you what, there is so much support out there for Team Rickshaw, for what you're doing. It's incredible.
And to prove it, we surprised them with messages from friends and family and some familiar faces.
Hey Rosie, you're doing amazing.
Everybody back home is so proud of you.
We love you.
Hey Sarah, it's Max Bowden here. Wishing you all of the luck in the world for your Rickshaw Challenge. We're all rooting for you here at EE.
Lauren, keep pedaling!
I'm Lewis, so inspiring lots of young people with and without disabilities. So keep up the great work.
Hey! Are you all right, everyone?
Yeah, bit emotional.
Yeah. There's a lot of support for the whole team.
I'm just speechless.
And it just makes you want to just keep pushing.
You guys are something else, you know that, don't you? It's been incredible. Talking the way that they have done is real testament in the fact that they want to spread awareness. You know, Children in Need has played such a massive part in their lives. And I just want to thank you all. seriously for donating in the way that you have done, because all those young children who really do need that money and are hoping that somebody is going to be there for them, you've allowed that to happen.
So please keep on donating what you can, because every mile that we pedal is to help even more children this year.
They are doing so brilliantly. But Matt, the thing is as well, and nobody says this, but a big thank you to you as because you are leading this team, as you always do, so brilliantly. And together, all of you, it's a sterling effort considering the plans have had to change so dramatically.
Yeah, it has had to take a handbrake turn. And, you know, it warms my heart to, weirdly, to be sat here doing this 10 years after we started a crazy ride from Edinburgh all the way down to London. And think of the 45 young riders that have been on board this rickshaw and the, you know, well over 4,000 miles that we've cycled. And every single one of them has their own personal reasons for doing this and their personal reasons to be thankful to children in need and to all you people who donate year after year. And the reasons why Owen wanted to do it are incredibly special too. And, well, here's his story.
I'm feeling pretty confident about the speech, but I'm quite nervous for doing it as well.
It's going to begin shortly. Five, four, three, two, one.
Growing up, I loved being with my family.
Some of my happiest memories are related to football and being with my dad.
He always made me feel happy and safe. We'd watch the match, eat fish and chips.
I treasure those good times. But in 2018, all that changed. Dad got ill one morning and I was told that he had died. It hit us all hard and I really struggled. At around the same time, me and my family lost our home. We ended up homeless. It was a really difficult time. My mum says that I went into myself and that I didn't say much. One day, she encouraged me to go to the North Belfast Playform, a project supported by children in need. There I met a project worker called Billy. He encouraged me to get involved with sports again, but also to share a little of what I went through. It really helped. Eventually, Mum found us a home, and I got back to sleeping in my own bed. Now I'm getting on with life. I'll always miss my dad and his smile, but I think he'd be proud of me. I've come a long way. This year, I'm riding the Rickshaw Challenge. We'll be cycling hundreds of miles to raise money. Your donations really can change the lives of children going through tough times. Please give if you can. Thank you.
Okay,
doesn't matter what life throws at you, you can just get through anything.
Really, really proud of him. Daddy would be super proud of him.
So there you have it. You know, Owen had to grow up incredibly quickly, but thanks to Children in Need, he had the chance of a childhood. And you know, you go right through that team. You've got Lewis, who is proud now. He's battled his bone cancer and he's proud of who he is and the way that he looks with his leg. You know, Rosie, so independent now in her own way. Sarah has got companionship through her hearing dog and she's flourished ever since. Lauren has the confidence to sing live on national television now. And she was such, you know, locked within her own world. And Jim, who started the challenge, he absolutely smashed it. He couldn't stay with us for long because of his condition, but he's at home and he's a massive part of this team. You know, and I think that's the word for me. It's resilience this year. We didn't know if the challenge was going to be able to continue, but everything that has been put in Team Rickshaw's way, they've overcome it and they're smashing out those miles. So, you know, it's very difficult to be asking this year for donations with everything that's going on. But there are thousands and thousands of children out there who are relying on that generosity. So if you possibly can, maybe this is the year to donate. And this is how you do it.
Donate 5, 10, 20 or £30.
Text the word 5.
10, 20 or 30.
Do 70701.
Text will cost your donation plus your standard network message charge, and 100% of your donation will go to BBC Children in Need. You must be 16 or over, and please do ask for the Bill Pays permission. For full terms and conditions and for more information, or to donate any amount that you like online, just go to bbc.co.uk/Pudsey. From all of us, thank you.
Yes, a huge thank you. And if you can donate, then please do. We're going to bring Owen in now. Owen, well done on your speech. It was incredibly powerful, and you could see how proud your mum was of you as well. And by the way, you're doing a brilliant job like the others this week. Matt has got something that he wants to say to you now. So, Matt, take it away.
Well, it's just sort of picking up on all of those messages that we played earlier on, because, Owen, there's one more that we didn't play you earlier on, but here's somebody that loves watching you, in fact, KSI.
Yo, what's up, Owen? How's it going, man? Just thought I'd pop in to say how proud of you I am, because doing this Rickshaw challenge, that's not easy, man. So, you know, big up for doing that and for doing it for such a good cause, children in need. Yeah, man, I'm proud of you. So keep going. And I'll see you in a bit. Peace.
Oh, hey. The only thing that would stop you pedalling, isn't it? A message from KSI. That's just lovely. Good on you. Good on you, Owen.
Yeah, he's gobsmacked.
Absolutely.
Isn't he?
And brilliant. Matt, you have been a hero.
Go on, Owen. What do you reckon?
Hero.
Go on, Owen. What do you reckon?
Oh, that's amazing. KSI is one of my favourite YouTubers.
We know.
Yeah.
And I didn't expect that. I don't know what to say, I'm speechless.
Oh,
oh,
brilliant.
Well, keep peddling, mate.
Yeah, thank you, Owen, and thank you, Matt, as well.
Magic.
Thank you so much.
Bless you.
Just a reminder that Children in Need is on BBC One tomorrow at 7 o'clock.
Come on, please, keep donating.
Last push.
Now.
Guests onto Matt and Team Rickshaw won't be here tomorrow, but enjoy Children in Need.
God bless.
See you Monday. Bye.